Good morning, this is Maani with Phoenix Tactical Solutions, and today let's talk about using the slide stop to drop the slide in case of an emergency reload. Now, Glock says that you shouldn't do that. That's why they say we call it a slide stop. It's one of those situations where it seems like the name dictates how it should be used. Now, let's talk about the fallacy in that. I'm sure you guys are familiar with Mohs, M-O-H-S, hardness scale of materials. So basically, what does that say? They have a system of ranking minerals from 1 to 10. And the harder minerals can scratch the softer minerals, and the same thing with metals. The harder metals can scratch the softer metals. The softer metals cannot scratch the harder metals. So this makes zero sense, because if you look at the hardness of the slide, it's much harder than the slide stop. So that logic is totally flawed. Now, I'm not a metallurgist or anything like that. I've just read up on this stuff, but it just doesn't make any sense to me. Absolutely zero sense. There is no way that repeated use of this slide stop is going to affect that notch in the slide to a point where the slide stop will no longer engage it. That's what Glock told me when I called them. And again, makes zero sense. I think I've been dropping my slide using the slide stop for a long time. So as Sean, we've never experienced any issues with it. So go ahead and do it. Just because something is named a slide stop doesn't dictate that that's the way it should be used. Now, I don't know what they call it in Austria. I'd be curious to know if any of you guys know what they call it in Austria. Is it also called the literal translation slide stop? So I'd love to hear from you guys if you know anything about that. But anyway, just drop the slide using the slide stop, not an issue at all. Thank you.